guys, this is Mary from Obubuchi. Thank you for joining this video. So you may have already seen in the title, but today's video is about a delicious, a little bit special tea. So you already know genmaicha and probably hojicha, but have you ever heard about hoji genmaicha? So for those who never heard about genmaicha and hojicha, I invite you to follow the links below to watch our previous videos about these teas. Genmaicha is basically a mix of green tea and roasted rice. Bancha green tea is the most often used for this kind of blend. Then hojicha is roasted green tea. Here again in Japan, most of the hojicha teas are made from bancha green tea that is harvested after the delicate sencha harvest. So yeah, if you simply combine the roasted rice of the genmaicha with some hojicha, you will get a super nice toasted flavor tea with some delicious nutty notes, hoji genmaicha. Now let's see how to brew this delicious tea with Simona.
Hello, this is Simona, and today I would like to brew hoji genmaicha with you. So this is a very interesting tea, hojicha mixed with roasted rice, so roastiness times two. And how to make this tea is actually quite simple. The way I would recommend is using a hot brew, and we can directly use boiling water. Don't really need to cool it down. My suggestion would be to take about 5 grams of hoji genmaicha and add about 200 milliliters of boiling water for just about 20 to 30 seconds. That should give us a very nice brew. So let's go and try to make it. I already have the leaves prepared, so just about 5 grams coming in and of water, 200 milliliters. All right, and now just need a little bit of patience. 20 to 30 seconds, we will have it ready. So this tea is actually a bubu's imagination, so it's not super common across Japan, but I think it's very interesting and it has a very unique taste and appearance. So I think it does have a chance, and I hope you will give it a try as well. So let's see what it brews at. The aroma is already filling the air, so I'm going to give it a try. Wow, really roasty, really nutty, beautiful toasty notes. This is a really nice warming tea. I think it can be had also at any time through the day, so very refreshing. This time as a hot brew, but if you would like to try this tea for hot summer days, it would make a really nice cold brew as well. So you can use about 10 grams of leaves with about 1 liter of water and leave it in the fridge for an hour. It will be an amazing cold brew as well. Alright, enjoy!